Hello children, welcome back once again to the grammar class. Now in the previous sessions what we have learnt, you already know it, right? Adjectives, compound adjectives, and we have also learnt about phrasal verbs. Now let us learn about noun. You already know what a noun is, you are very much familiar with it. Okay, everybody knows what a noun is. What's a noun? A noun is a name given to a person, a place, an animal, or a thing. Okay, we all use it every day, and we know everyone, even a primary child can tell what a noun is, right? But being in class 5, we should know what are the different kinds of nouns, what are the classifications of nouns. Okay, that will help us to know what kind of noun it is, what is the noun we are using. Okay, that is very important for us. Now, there are different types of nouns, and I have written few nouns for you here to explain to you. Now, in that, first let us go with the common noun. Some of you must be aware of it, but once again, focus here, children. A common noun, as the name says, is a name given in common to one group. A common noun is a name given in common to a group. If you take girl, a group of girl, boy, school, tree, a common name given to a group. Now, that's why we are saying that it is a common noun. Okay, now when you come down a little bit, you see children here, proper noun I'm saying. Now please see the difference. Proper noun. Now here the name is what? Proper. So particular. Not common, proper. So properly, particularly we are calling one person or one thing among the common things. Now if you see the examples right below, I have given common noun girl. In proper name, I gave a particular name to the girl, Ria. Now boy is a common group. Okay. Now particular noun is John, a name given in particular. School, common name. Particularly I am talking about Lotus Lab School. And tree, common name. I'm calling a particular tree name, birch. So, common name is a name given in common, but proper name is a name that is given particularly to one thing. Okay, like that you can also say common name mountain. Then what will be the proper noun? Himalayas, Aravali. Okay, if I say common name ocean, common noun ocean. What will you say? Say any proper noun for it. Atlantic, Pacific. Okay, if I give a common noun, subject, what will be the proper noun? English, Telugu, particular subject. So, that is how you have to differentiate a common and a proper noun. Now, let us move on to the collective noun. Now, see the name children once again. Collective means a collection, a name given to one collection. Now, if you see the example, a flock of birds. A flock of birds. The flock is nothing but the collection of birds. A cluster of spiders. Collection of spiders is called a cluster. Now, some more examples can you tell me, children? Yes. You can say army. Army. What is army? Collection of soldiers. Then, some more examples. Bouquet. What is a bouquet, children? We give it on birthdays. Collection of flowers. So, a name given for collection of things is called collective noun. A fleet of sheep. A collection of sheep is called fleet. Now, let us move on to abstract noun. Let us move on to abstract noun. What is abstract? Which can only be felt but cannot be touched. It can be felt but it cannot be touched. Now, abstract noun, if you see the example, joy. You can feel the happiness, you feel the joy, but it cannot be touched in person. Just like your pencil or any other material thing, just like your material noun, you cannot touch it. You can only feel it. It is a kind of a feeling or an idea within you. Upset. The bird was upset when the birch tree rejected to give shelter to it. It's a feeling. Okay. Next, puzzled. The bird was puzzled. Then hunger. Poverty. Okay. All these things which can only be felt but cannot be touched are called abstract nouns. They are feelings or some ideas that represent in you, but You cannot touch it. Now, let me tell you, children, when you are trying to differentiate different kind of nouns, first you classify them. What is a common noun? What is a proper noun? What is a collective noun? What is an abstract noun? Then it will be easy for you to identify what kind of noun it is. Okay, now in your first lesson of the textbook, after the completion of the lesson, if you refer to the textbook grammar, you can see there is some information given about the nouns. The information about the nouns, that is the common, the proper, the collective and the abstract nouns are given. Now, if you go through it, there is one passage followed by it. And in this passage, there are different kinds of nouns. And your work is to identify them and just circle or box them and write down what kind of noun it is. Whether it falls under these four categories. It will fall under the four categories. So you have to just underline it or box it and write whether it is collective means C. Just write C below it. If it is proper, write P. Just circle it, vowel it or box it, whatever you want to do it. And just write down whether it is a collective noun, a proper noun or a common noun or abstract noun. And this exercise will really help you a lot in understanding what kind of a noun it is. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.